وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإذ قال إبراهيم لأبيه آزر أتتخذ أصناما آلهة إني أراك وقومك في ضلال مبين وكذلك نري إبراهيم ملكوت السماوات والأرض وليكون من الموقنين فلما جن عليه الليل رأى كوكبا قال هذا ربي فلما أفل قال لا أحب الآفلين فلما رأى القمر بازغا قال هذا ربي فلما أفل قال لئن لم يهدني ربي لأكونن من القوم الضالين فلما رأى الشمس بازغة قال هذا ربي هذا أكبر فلما أفلت قال يا قوم إني بريء مما تشركون إني وجهت وجهي للذي فطر السماوات والأرض حنيفا وما أنا من المشركين صدق الله العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. The meaning and explanation of Surah Al-An'am are going on. Today we are going to do start from ayah 74. In the previous ayat, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been told several ways to argue and prove the righteousness of his prophethood, authority of his prophethood, and the oneness of Allah to the mushrikeen, the people who believed in multiple gods. So this discussion is continuing here, and there is another very wise way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is being advised to argue with these people in. Because the person of Sayyidina Ibrahim ala nabiyyina alayhi salatu wasalam was respected by all the Arabs. They considered him their ancestor, and all of them respected and all of them claimed to be following his deen, although they had come up with many other things which were never taught by Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to remind them of the way Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, just like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, had to convince his people, had to talk with his people, and to try to prove them logically that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one and the other gods that they have taken, they are false. So remind them of Wa idh qala Ibrahim, that should be remembered, the time where Ibrahim alayhi salam said to his abi, Azar. So Azar, as we have explained, I think somewhere else here, that Azar was, some Mufassirin have went with the understanding that Azar was his real father. A lot have also gone with that Azar was not his real father, but he was his uncle. And Azar was not his real name. His name comes as Tariq. He was another person, but in the language Arab, it was very common practice that the uncle would also be called the father. So this person Azar, Ibrahim alayhi salam talked to him. Atattakhidhu asnaman aliha, do you make asnam, sanam, or idols, statues, aliha, as your ilah, as your as your god? Do you take them as your god? Do you make these idols as your, those who are worshipped? Inni araka wa qawmaka fi dhalalin mubin, I see you and your people are in express, manifest, apparent error, an open error. From this only ayah, this ayah alone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us many things. Number one is that when Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam talked, his conversation was with the highest, most respectable person of his nation. No, not his nation, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, قَوْمَكَ إِنِّي أَرَاكَ وَقَوْمَكَ, your nation. Although Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, according to most narrations, was related by blood to this person called Azar, whoever he was, either his father or his uncle, but Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam told him that I see your nation on an open dhalala, in an open manifest error. So the first thing that we learn is that the people who want to call people towards deen, it is praiseworthy for them if they start at the top, if there is somebody who is influential and they can start with him, with that personality, it is praiseworthy. They can do so. Secondly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah, according to Mufti Shafi rahimahullah and other mufassirin, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has presented the two nation theory. The two nation theory is that Muslims are one nation no matter where they belong, no matter what country they are in. And kuffar are another nation. When somebody submits to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then all their ties with those that do not believe so, with the mushrikeen, are severed. Their national ties, their family ties, all of them, they hold no importance. And this is learned from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has identified himself as nahnu qawmun muslimun. We are a nation of Muslims. We are a nation of Muslims. Borders do not matter. Similarly, in the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Islam had spread, Islamic identity had gained precedence over all the other minor Arab identities. So if somebody was asked, who are you? They will not say that we are from the Quraysh or we are from the such and such tribe, but they will first say that we are from the nation of Islam. We are from the Qawm of Muslimun. From the nation of Muslimun. So that is, here Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam told him that I see you and your people, you and your Qawm, on a severe manifest error. وَكَذَٰلِكَ نُرِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَلَكُوتُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلِيَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُقِنِينَ. Thus, we showed Ibrahim the kingdom of the heavens and the earth, so that he might be firm in belief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed some special signs to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and gave him some special knowledge and some special wisdom, which is going to come in the future ayat, the explanation of which, so that he becomes steadfast. فَلَمَّا جَنَّ عَلَيْهِ اللَّيْلُ رَآ كَوْكَبًا. When the night enveloped him, رَآ كَوْكَبًا, he saw كَوْكَبًا, a star. قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي, he said, this is my Lord. So the explanation, what should be understood, is that Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam never left the faith of belief in the oneness of Allah, but this was his way of bringing his people to sense. That as per your understanding, if this is my Lord, if this is my Lord, then we are going to see the reality of this God very soon, this God that you claim to be, very soon. Falamma afala, then that disappeared, it vanished. Qala la uhibbul afilin, he said it very clearly, something that these people could also understand. That, see, if you are claiming this to be your God, then it has vanished. And gods should not vanish. Somebody who is worshipped should not disappear. So he said that I do not love those who disappear, those who set one day, those who vanish. In this ayah also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us a quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and the quality of the one who is worshipped. That they are also to be loved. They are also to be loved. These go together. Worship and loving the one that you are worshipping. These go together. You do not separate them out from each other. So he's saying that I do not love those who vanish. فَلَمَّا رَأَ الْقَمَرَ, then he saw the qamar or the moon. بَازِغًا, rising. قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي. So it might be on the same night or it might be on a different night. He said, if your claim is right, then this might be our Lord, because these people used to worship idols and stars. Nujum. فَلَمَّا أَفَلَ, then that moon also said, قَالَ لَإِن لَمْ يَهْدِنِي رَبِّي, then he said to his people that had my Allah not been, لَإِن لَمْ يَهْدِنِي رَبِّي, had my Allah not been constantly guiding me. So He has been constantly guiding me, and that is why I am proving these things to you. I am showing these signs to you. La illam yahdini Rabbi. Otherwise, I would have been from among your nation. La akunanna min al-qawm al-dhalin. Your nation, the nation of express, manifestly, those people who are on error and have gone astray, then I would have been part of you as well. But I am not your part. I am not part of your nation. I am somebody who believes in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I am constantly being guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمَّا رَأَ الشَّمْسَ بَازِغًا. Then the biggest of them all, the next morning, some of us have written, the sun came up, which is the bigger of all three, the biggest of all three. So he said, if this is your Lord, this is the biggest. فَلَمَّا رَأَ الشَّمْسَ بَازِغًا قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي. That this is my Lord, هَذَا أَكْبَر. This is the biggest of them all. فَلَمَّا أَفَلَتْ. But that also said, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. He said that, O nation, I am free, I am away, I am clear, I have no relation with the shirk that you do, your act of ascribing partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ حَنِيفًا. I have indeed turned my face straight towards the one who created the heavens and the earth. وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And I'm not one of those who associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These heavens and the earth, the signs that I've shown you, of course, obviously there is somebody who's controlling them. I have turned my face in a way that I do not think about, I do not have any space in my ibadah for any of these that you associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am free of your shirk. I have totally turned towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. I am not from among those who associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This argument was very clear, because this was by a person who was, as I said, respected by the Arab people, and they considered him pious and righteous, and they also knew, and they had also heard, and they were reminded by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of the same situation that Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam had gone through, this exact same thing. And then in the future ayat, وَحَاجَّهُ قَوْمُهُ. His people also fought him, his people also argued him, and then he also faced their arguments and tried to convince them, and also faced hardships from them. So inshallah we are going to read about it tomorrow, but this was an argument that was very strong for the mushrikeen, after which they did not have any other thing to stand on. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذي أهلك وخاصتك. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.